I'm gonna show you 3 hacking devices you can create with the Raspberry Pi Zero W. I also have a 2. Almost dropped it in my coffee. And a Raspberry Pi Pico. Now, this is my first time playing with a Raspberry Pi Zero, and I have to admit, pretty stinking cool. And the hacking projects you can do with these are kind of amazing. Why not just go for a Raspberry Pi 4? You gotta be rich to have a Raspberry Pi 4. It's the new flex. It's like Supreme. But the Raspberry Pi Zero, hey, you can actually get these. Now, they're not as cheap as they used to be, but I got this one, the Raspberry Pi Zero W, for like 40 bucks. And I'm telling you, you can turn this into a killer hacking device. So we'll start with him and the first hacking project, a bad USB. Like, bad USBs are already bad, but this is badder. I'll show you. The project to turn your Pi Zero into a bad USB is the PwnPi. Poor phone pie. Now, some of you may recognize this project because it's stinking old. In fact, its last commit was like 6 years ago, which had me thinking, does this actually still work? The good news is that if you scroll down a bit, you can see the creator of this said, nah, we're not doing that anymore. And now we have the PwnPi Aloha. I want to say Aloha every time I see that. What's it stand for? I don't know. Maybe I'll find out when I go to the GitHub. So let's go to the new one, the Aloha. Okay, this one's a bit better. A commit at least 4 years ago. Not great, but it might work, right? Oh, and there's what it stands for, a little offensive appliance. Now, the PwnPi, PwnPi, at its core, is a bad USB. So you plug it into a computer via USB, and it does bad things. Steals stuff, makes your mouse wiggle, opens up a Rickroll. That's what it does. Now, you're probably aware of the most popular one, the USB rubber ducky. Actually, I think I have a few. Oh, come on.
Nope, not there, hold on.
About it. I got a lot of hacking stuff. This is the USB rubber ducky from Hack5. It's amazing. It looks like nothing, and that's by design. In fact, I just ordered a bunch of regular USBs off of Amazon, and I mean, here's what they look like. They look just like this. The idea is that you trick people into plugging this in. So that's a bad USB. So why is the Raspberry Pi Zero W running PwnPi badder? Here's why. It does a ton of other stuff that I'm about to cover here in a bit. But the main thing I love it for, the reason I love it, is that once this thing is powered up and you plug it into anything with a USB, it has a little Wi-Fi network that you can then connect to and then control your device on the fly. It has a nifty little web GUI and you can attack to your heart's content. This opens up a ton of things you can do. I do not condone anything illegal, but messing with your friends is really, really fun. Now, one of the main ingredients that makes a bad USB bad is the fact that when you connect it to your computer, it's like, nah, I'm not a USB, I'm something else. I'm an Ethernet adapter. I'm a keyboard, I'm a mouse. It can be anything. It's like the Pokemon Ditto. So this little device morphs into something else, tricks your computer, and it works on like every computer I know of. It's pretty scary. So let's not wait. Let's set it up real quick. It's actually not that hard. First, what do you need? You'll want the Raspberry Pi Zero W at least. It gives you wireless. You want that. And if you're smarter than me, you'll get the WH, which has the pins already soldered on. Now, that's not important for our project right now, but it will be handy for a project later. Just get that one if you can. And then, like all Raspberry Pi projects, you'll need a SD card. I'm rocking, I've got a 32 GB SD card, micro SD. You'll need some way to read that card, so micro SD card reader, adapter. My writing is getting so bad, I'm not gonna fix it. And then finally, you'll need a micro USB cable. Micro USB to type A USB, right? That's what it is. Now, I think that's it. Oh, you need coffee. Everything in IT requires coffee. Never chucked out coffee. The first thing we'll do is download the latest image of Aloha PwnPi thing. So I'll go to the top here, find the releases tag, click on that, find the latest one, which is the beta back in 2020. Just deal with it. That's what we have. That's all we got. Click on it and scroll down a bit until you see the XZ image. And we'll download that sucker. Now, while that's downloading, I know I'll get this question. Does this work on the Raspberry Pi Zero W2, the 2, which I have right here? I don't believe so. The way the wireless is configured is a bit different. And the 2 is more expensive, so just go with the 0, W. Now also, while it's downloading, we'll want the Raspberry Pi Imager. It's my favorite way to write images to a micro SD card, which I have right here. So just Google Raspberry Pi Imager. You'll find a link to it. I'll put a link below too. And then download for Windows, Mac, or Linux. Next, I'll take my micro SD card, put it into my little adapter here, my USB adapter, and plug that into, oh my gosh, what happened? And plug that into my computer, I almost broke it. From here, we'll choose our OS. I'll scroll to the bottom here and click on Use Custom, find my Aloha image there, open, and then choose my storage, making sure you select the right one, don't overwrite anything important. There's my 32 GB SD card. And finally, click on Write. Do I wanna continue? Yes, I do. Now at this moment, the time I'm launching this video, it's Pi Day. And Oracle is the sponsor of this video, and they want me to say this. This is weird. Let's just go with it, okay? The flaky, buttery texture. The decadent mouthfeel. This is getting weird. The gentle snap of the crust. By joining Oracle and Ampere at Pi Day, a virtual event for developers, you'll get the satisfaction of baking a pie. I don't think I've ever baked a pie. I mean, I've baked plenty of these guys. That's what they're talking about, probably, I would assume. And there's no messy cleanup with this. And by the end of the day, you'll have learned how to build a containerized app on the Oracle Cloud infrastructure. So essentially, you're gonna learn how to containerize an app instead of baking a pie. That's what we're talking about here. Now, no matter where you are in the world, just follow along. It's March 14th, which is today, if you're watching this on March 14th. It's Pi Day. And you can follow along with cloud experts who, we're told, are basically the Julia Childs of cloud-native app development. Oracle, y'all making me say some weird things. So anyways, you should probably register. Click the link below. At least do it for me because I had to read that. But also, it does sound pretty cool because that's one thing that people always struggle with. Like, they can understand what containers are, but then how do you take an app and containerize a regular app? You're gonna learn that. But seriously, thank you to Oracle for sponsoring this video and making things like this happen. And I love sponsors like this because they're kind of doing what I'm doing. They're helping you learn something. So go learn something. Click the link below. And speaking of baking pies, mine is done. Okay, I'm pretty excited. I'm gonna grab it, pull it out, and slide that bad boy into my Raspberry Pi W0 thingy. Now at this point, there's not much more to do than to just play with it. So let's play with it. I'm gonna find my micro USB cable. I lost it. And I'm gonna plug the micro USB side of it into the port, obviously, but you'll notice on your Pi Zero, there are actually two micro USB slots. One says USB, one says power in. See that? For what we're doing right now, I'm plugging mine into my computer. I wanna plug into the USB port. What this will do is two things. Power it up, and also connect it to your computer for what we want to play with. Nothing crazy will happen just yet, don't worry. Or maybe you should be worried. And you'll see a little light start blinking, magic start happening, just give it a moment, give it a moment. I'm gonna leave my, I don't know where to put them. Just gonna put them like right here, don't go anywhere. Now while we're waiting, you'll want another device. So like get your phone or a laptop. I'm gonna grab a laptop real quick. Got it. And from here, you're gonna search in your wireless connections and look for, something looks kinda crazy. Bam, bam, explosion, computer, PwnPi. Connect to that network. The wireless password will be this guy right here. Let me show you. Yeah, there it is right there. PSK is MAME82 blah, blah, blah. You got it right there. And once you're connected, we're gonna go to this URL. Which by the way, this is so cool, right? Because you can be on your phone, laptop, or whatever, set this guy somewhere. I mean, obviously plug it into someone's computer, walk away within range, and connect to it. So let's do that. 172.24.0.1 port 8000. There it is, that's easy. Now right from the start, it's already pretty cool. We could also, if we wanted to, SSH into it. It'll be root at the IP address. And the default password will be Tor, backward reverse root. So T-O-O-R. And you can tell from here that we're actually using Kali Linux. Bet you didn't know that, didn't see that coming. How exciting is this? And whether you wanna use the terminal or the GUI, it's your choice. Pick your poison, but I'll show you some GUI because it's more visual and we're doing a visual thing right now. We're making a video. I can't cover everything, but I'll show you how I can jiggle my mouse on my computer. You wanna see that? That's pretty cool. I'm gonna go to the HID script menu option. Now the main difference between this bad or bad USB and the Ducky is that the Ducky uses Ducky script, which is this custom thing that Hack5 came up with. This guy uses HID script, which is, I think, a standard, and it's written in JavaScript. So really you can just do whatever you want. I'll show you what it looks like. I mean, it's right here, you can see it. And actually I just noticed this, you can import a Ducky script and it'll just translate it for you. And why that's valuable is because, check this out. There's a huge library of Ducky script payloads that the community creates. So you can use this here. Anyways, I'm gonna load and prepend something. I'm gonna do the HID test, click okay. Now watch my computer here, watch it, the one it's plugged into. I'm gonna run it. Oh, stuff's happening. I'm not doing anything, look at that. It's just a test, right? All right, so I can stop at any time. I'm gonna stop it, ooh, stop. But how cool is that? And there are also PwnPi payloads that are designed to do some crazy things. I haven't tested all of these, but a lot of things you could possibly do, like capturing logins, disabling security, grabbing passwords, a good old Rickroll, PowerShell, reverse shell, exfiltration, you name it, it could probably do whatever you want. Because in this instance, the USB is pretending to be a mouse and a keyboard. That's how your computer sees it. Like, let's dive into the Rickroll one real quick. Simple, I'm gonna add that here. So I'm gonna type this out. Notice there's kind of a little IDE for us right here in the browser. Doing this on the fly is so powerful, man. Your imagination's the limit, that's it. Okay, let's run it, see what happens. My video's wrong, let me do it again. There we go. How cool is that? Now, whether you're a hacker or not, that's just fun. Be able to control this remotely and make your friends or your bosses or whoever's computer kind of spooky. Now, I'm not condoning hacking, but little funny prank. That's just fun. Make your mom think she's hacked. That's just a funny thing. Now again, there's a lot more you can do with this. You can control trigger actions, what happens when it's plugged in. You can have a whole set of things just go off. You can change Wi-Fi settings. You can change the network that the USB is operating on. You can do all kinds of stuff. So even though this is super old it still works pretty well. So 40 bucks, that's not too bad. Now, 40 bucks is too steep, I totally get that. We still have this guy, an even smaller Raspberry Pi. I'm gonna keep pulling out smaller ones. This is the Raspberry Pi Pico. Not very powerful, but you can turn this into a bad USB. I've already made a video on this, how you can turn this little guy into a bad USB. You can get two of these, like a two pack for 14 bucks. And that's kind of stupid awesome. And they're available, like you, and so is this, by the way, but they're just crazy valuable. You can buy these in bulk like you wouldn't believe. Buy 20. And similar to the Pwn Pi, you can use Ducky Script to do a ton of payloads. Again, just watch that video. It was pretty cool. Now this next project is just so stinking cool. Let me unplug him. Here we go. Power down. I made a sound effect. This one I'm gonna keep with me all the time and take it with me everywhere I go. It's called the Pwn Agachi. If you're old like me, you'll remember the Tamagotchi, although Tamagotchi made a comeback, didn't it? My daughter's just got one for Christmas like 2 years ago. Things always come around. Now seriously, here's the page. Pwn Agachi. And you'll want to read this because I'm not doing it justice, but essentially it does use AI to tune its parameters to get better at pwning Wi-Fi things to whatever environment you're exposing it to. Again, read all this, but let's set it up real quick. Now, ideally, you'll get the Raspberry Pi 0WH that has pins already set up so you can buy a screen. Oh, it's so cool. I bought a screen, but I don't have pins and I don't have a soldering gun with me right now. So I can't use it, but you don't need a screen. And if you want to keep this project bare bones, you can do what I'm about to do and just have this. And you can see this little cool screen on a web UI. I'll show you how to set it up right now. It's super simple. So first we're going to download the latest Pwn Agachi image. Let's go find it. I'll have links below, but I believe it's going to be, I'm gonna click on an installation and go to flashing an image and click on the latest Pwn Agachi file, which takes me here to GitHub, which is version 1.55, as of the time of this recording. I'll download this zip right here and let that download. And just like the Pwn Pi, you'll need the Raspberry Pi imager so we can write that image to an SD card, a micro SD card. So while it's downloading, let's get our SD card. You can use the same one if you want to replace your previous project. Plug it into our little USB adapter and plug that into our computer. Now, real quick, before you just like go, oh, I already know where he's going with this. I'm just gonna go forward for the next 5 steps by myself. Don't do it yet. There's one thing we have to do differently here. We have to edit a few files to make some magic possible. I'll show you what I mean. Oh, mine is done. Okay. Now we're gonna unzip it. Did I scare you? I kind of scared myself. Let's unzip that sucker. Extract all. I like the tangy whip of a file unzip. Do y'all watch The Office? My wife and I always quote that to each other. We are lame. Okay, there's our image file right there. We're gonna open up our Raspberry Pi imager just as before. We're gonna choose that file by going to use custom, finding it inside that folder. There it is. And then just as before, choosing our SD card and clicking on write. So far, pretty standard. We'll take a little coffee break and we'll let that finish. Okay, I'm back. Verifying's for suckers. No, you should verify, but I'm under a time constraint. Done, my Pwn Agachi's almost ready. Don't do anything yet. Now, what you wanna do is go find the SD card mount. You might have to like unplug and plug it in again, like I just did. There it is. So you're gonna open up that boot drive. This config is gonna allow us to connect to our Raspberry Pi Zero's internet connection. It's NIC.
I didn't get that.
Shh. Via the USB cable. I know, right? It's so cool. Here in this boot drive, we're gonna create a new file. Go ahead and do it. I'm gonna right click, say new text document. We're gonna name that config.toml, T-O-M-L, just like that. Now we're going to edit that file. I'll open that with Notepad, the best text editor in the world. Now I will have this code below, but they do have an example here on, I don't know why I said it like that, on Pwn Agachi's website. We'll paste that here, but we're not quite done yet. There's a few things we wanna add here to enable our UI for the web UI. Right now it's by default just enabling the UI for the little screen. So this is probably gonna work for you already out of the box. You can also tell it to ignore certain Wi-Fi networks. So you would put your SSID here if you wanted to for these two functions. I'm not gonna worry about that right now. I'm gonna paste all this in there. Again, stuff is all below. Changing my username to admin and my password to something super secure, admin. This is simply the web UI login and that's it. I'm gonna hit Control S to save or Command S wherever you are, Mac, Linux, you know the drill. So now you should have a config.toml file with all that information. You can now remove it and plug that into your Raspberry Pi Zero like I'm gonna do right now. Let's do this. Raspberry Pi Zero. Pwn Agachi. Now again, we're going back to our micro USB cable, so find that. And just like our previous example, we're gonna take the micro USB side and plug that into the micro USB port, like so. Not the power one, the USB one. And we'll plug the other end into a computer of your choice. I'm gonna do my Mac right here. Now before I plug it in, there's two things I want you to notice. First, check your network adapters. So this will be different whether you're on Mac or Windows, but here in Mac, I can do an ifconfig in the terminal, and I can just kind of keep an eye on how many I have. You want to keep an eye on that. Also, I can go to settings, system settings, go to network, and keep an eye on how many adapters I have right there. That should change if we did everything right. Time to plug them in. I'm gonna plug them in right now and give it a moment to boot. Give it a few minutes because technology, it's gonna have to come up and do all its things. Ah, you see that? So something just happened there. I have a new RNDNIS Ethernet gadget connection. RNDIS is something I'm actually new to. It's pretty cool, but it's essentially USB Ethernet kind of thing that your computers will recognize. And if I do ifconfig once more, there's a new interface, EN9. Now I know I'm ready to play when I see that I have a self-assigned IP and it's connected here on the RNDIS Ethernet gadget. To make some magic happen for me to connect to my Ponogachi, I'm gonna have to change some things here. I'm gonna open this up, and this, again, will be different across whatever OS you're on. But I'm gonna set a static IP instead of relying on DHCP here. Go to details, TCP IP, change that from using DHCP to manually. The IP address will be 10.0.0.1, subnet mask 255.255.255.0/24, and the router will be 10.0.0.1. Click on OK. Now you'll know it's working when you can go over here to your terminal or command prompt, wherever you are, and ping 10.0.0.2. That's the Ponogachi. Got it, okay. I'm gonna stop that. Gonna open up a web browser, navigate to 10.0.0.2, port 8080. Yeah, full disclosure, I had to re-plug it in again and repower it up, and it works, okay? So go into 10.0.0.2, port 8080, log in with my super secret admin configuration, and look how cute that is. It's cute, right? Now this thing can do a lot, but essentially you can leave it up and running and it will hack for you. Right now it's in manual mode, so it's not doing anything cool. You can see it at the bottom right here. I can restart in auto mode, which I'll do right now. Shouldn't take very long. And you'll start to see it do things on my wireless network. Ah, there we go, it's up now. That thing's hilarious. I can't take it seriously. Ah, it found my Wi-Fi. Now look at it, it's finding it all. Those are all my wireless, Nick, blur those out. And it will monitor all kinds of things, do some de-auth, pull some stuff. It's crazy. And the idea is you want to keep it on all the time. The more you leave it on, the more wireless stuff you expose it to, the smarter it gets. So what I'm going to do actually is, let me show you, is get a little USB power bank. So what I want to do is when I'm in an environment where I'm allowed to do stuff, I will plug it in, let it go crazy and get smarter. Now this does a lot more and the technology behind this is really, really interesting. And it doesn't have to be a Raspberry Pi Zero. It can be a Raspberry Pi 3, 4, but you should definitely try this out. All the links below. Look at him go, he's just doing kinds of crazy stuff. Now for the third project, this one's kind of simple and easy. You can simply install Kali Linux onto your Raspberry Pi Zero. So like going through here, I can choose the operating system on the Raspberry Pi Imager. Go to, let's see, what are the other ones? Other specific purpose OS. And there it is, Kali Linux, and they have all the different versions. They have it for 0.2.0. They got a thing called PyTail, which actually allow you to, this is nuts, it allow you to use your Android phone as a screen and controller for your Pi, yeah. So you can carry around with you everywhere, plug it into your Android, and suddenly you get this like little hacking environment. It's kind of crazy. They also have one with PwnPi that you can download right from here, but it didn't work for me. And that's why I'm showing it to you last here, because you might see that and go, oh, so cool, I can do this, Chuck. You didn't, why didn't you show this from the beginning? Dude, I tried it, it doesn't work. Go from the GitHub, the method we went through, that works. And from there, you'll have Kali Linux on here. You can connect it to your wireless network via WPA supplicant. I'm not gonna cover that right here. You can connect a keyboard and display and everything if you want to, but it's just really cool to have Kali Linux, a hacking OS on a little small device. Crazy powerful. And finally, bonus, there's one project I really wanted to show you and I really hoped it would work, but it didn't work. It's a thing called Poison Tap. And the promise of this is that you'll connect your Raspberry Pi Zero to a computer. It doesn't have to be open or unlocked or anything. It can just be sitting there. And it would somehow take all the network traffic and sniff. It would sniff everything, bring it all in, and send it up to a web server that you have configured. And you just got a ton of data about a machine. It was all the rage back in 2016 when Sammy K here came out with it. Now no one cares and it doesn't work anymore. I tried for hours. But such a cool idea, right? Like I really wanted that to work. I set up the web server, I set up the Raspberry Pi Zero, no data came out, nothing. I could have, you know, troubleshooted it longer, but who has time for that? Anyways, that's our hacking projects. Happy Pi Day. Let me know which ones you're going to try out, if probably all of them. You should do all of them right now. And again, massive shout out to Oracle for sponsoring this video. Check out their Pi Day stuff. It's happening right now. So like when you're done with this video, go learn how to do container stuff with apps. Video over, bye.